गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू। टुडेज टॉपिक इज एपिथेलियल टिश्यू। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ टिश्यू। बॉडी टिश्यू कैन बी क्लासिफाइड इनटू फोर बेसिक टाइप्स अकॉर्डिंग टू स्ट्रक्चर एंड फंक्शन। फर्स्ट इज एपिथेलियल टिश्यू विच कवर्स बॉडी सरफेस एंड लाइंस, होलो ऑर्गन्स, बॉडी कैविटी एंड डक्ट्स, and it also form glands. Second types of tissue is connective tissue, which protect and supports the body and its organ. Various types of connective tissue binds organ together. As per its name, it's connect two part of the body. It store energy as a fat and also provide immunity to disease causing organism. Third tissue is muscular tissue, which generates the physical force that needed to make body structure move and generates body heat. And last types of tissue is nervous tissue, that detect change in variety of condition inside and outside the body and responds by generating action potential that activate muscular contraction and glandular secretion. Now, classification of epithelial tissue. In the last slides, we have discussed types of tissue. Now, types of epithelial tissue. So, epithelial tissue may be divided into two types. One is covering and lined epithelium, and second one is glandular epithelium. Covering and lined epithelial forms the outer cover of the skin and some internal organs. It forms inner lining of blood vessels, ducts and body cavity, and interior of the respiratory system, digestive system, urinary and reproductive system. Whereas glandular epithelium makes up the secreting portion of the gland, such as thyroid gland, adrenal gland and sweat glands. Now, covering and lining epithelial tissue are classified in various types according to two characteristics. One is arrangement of layers and second is shape of the cell. First class, simple epithelial. Simple epithelium is further classified in the fourth class, simple squamous epithelium, simple cuboidal epithelium, simple columnar epithelium, non-ciliated and ciliated, and pseudostratified columnar epithelium, non-ciliated and ciliated. Second class is stratified epithelium. Stratified epithelium again classified in the four class, stratified squamous epithelium, keratinized and non-keratinized, stratified cuboidal epithelium, stratified columnar epithelium and transitional epithelium. Now, first of all, we will discuss first class, simple epithelium. Simple epitheliums, we have again it is classified in simple squamous epithelium. So we discuss first simple squamous epithelium. It is the first type of simple epithelium. Simple squamous epithelium consists of single layer of flat cells. It is the characteristic of simple squamous epithelium. Simple means it contains single layer, and squamous means it contains flat cells that resembles, that look like tiled floor when viewed from the apical surface. When we view from top surface, it's look like tiles on the floor. Second characteristic of this tissue is its nucleus is generally present in center and its shape is oval or sphere. Simple squamous epithelium is present at sites where process of filtration, example blood filtration in the kidney, and diffusion, example diffusion of oxygen into blood vessels of the lungs. So it is generally present in kidney and lungs, because kidney is doing filtration and lungs doing diffusion. So it is not found in the body area that are subject to mechanical stress, wear and tear. Simple squamous epithelium that are lines the heart, blood vessels and lymphatic vessels is known as endotheliums. and the types that form the epithelial layer of serous membrane, such as pericardium, pleura, and peritoneum, is called mesotheliums. This is the figure of simple squamous epithelium, and these are the cell of simple squamous epithelial tissue. Its nucleus is present in centers, and its cells are flat in shape. It is basement membrane, and after the epithelial tissue, second layer. Second types of epithelial tissue is simple cuboidal epithelium. The cuboidal, its names indicates the shape of the cell is cube shape. The cuboidal shape of the cells in this tissue. Cells nuclei are usually round and centrally located. This nucleus is also present in center, but its shape is round. Simple cuboidal epithelial is found in location of simple cuboidal epithelium is thyroid gland and kidney, and it performs the function of secretion and absorption. Third is simple columnar epithelium. Simple means it contains single layer of cells. Columnar means the shape of the cell is column shape. Column means the width is the height is more than width. When viewed from the side, the cells of simple columnar epithelium appear like column, means taller than they are wide, means height is more than their width, with oval nucleus near to the base. Simple columnar epithelium exist in two forms. There are two types of simple columnar epithelium. One is non-ciliated and second one is ciliated. Non-ciliated simple columnar epitheliums contain two types of cell: column epithelial cells with microvilli at their apical surface and globulate cells. Microvilli, what is microvilli? Microvilli is finger-like cytoplasmic projections that increase the surface area of the plasma membrane, and so it increase the rate of absorption by the cell. Globulate cell are modified columnar epithelial cell. Globulate cell secrete mucus, and generally mucus is slightly slicky fluid, and it is present in apical surface. Before it is released, mucus accumulate in upper portion of the cell, and it cause it to bulge out and making the whole cell resemble a goblet or wine glass. Secreted mucus act as a lubricant for the lining of digestive, respiratory, reproductive, and urinary tract. And mucus also helps prevent destruction of stomach's lining by acidic gastric juice secreted by the stomach. Second parts of simple columnar epithelium is ciliated. The columnar epithelial cell with cilia at their apical surface means it the upper surface contain the cilia. In the certain part of the smaller airway of the respiratory tract, globulate cell are interspersed among the ciliated columnar epithelia. Mucus secreted by globulate cell form the film over the airway surface that trap inhaled foreign particles. Due to this mucus, some foreign particles are trapped, and the cilia beat in unison, moving the mucus and any foreign particles toward the throats, where they can be coughed up or swallowed or split out. Coughing and sneezing speed up the movement of cilia and mucus. Cilia also help move oocytes expel from the ovary through the fallopian tube into the uterus. So here in these figures we can see, here it is the ciliated simple columnar epithelial cell. So it in the upper surface, meaning apical part, it, there is the cilia is present. And in non-ciliated simple columnar epithelium, here instead of cilia, microvilli is present. In these both figures, the shape of the cell is column shapes, because its name indicates columnar, means column shapes, and it is simple, so it is in present in one single layer. And then after that there is the basement membrane, and after epithelial tissue, the second layer is connective tissue. लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ द सिंपल कॉलमनर सिंपल एपिथेलियल टिश्यू इज सुडो स्ट्रेटिफाइड कॉलमनर एपिथेलियम. As noted earlier, pseudo-stratified columnar epithelium appear to have the several layer because the nucleus of the cells are at various depth. Even though all the cells are attached to the basement membrane in single layer, some cells do not extend to the apical surface. But when we view from side, these features give the false impression of multi-layer tissue. Thus, the name is pseudo-stratified epithelium. In pseudo-stratified ciliated columnar epithelium, the cells that extend to the surface either secrete mucus or bear cilia. The secreted mucus traps the foreign particles that already we have discussed in the last slides, and cilia that sweep away mucus for eventual elimination from the body. Pseudo-stratified non-ciliated columnar epithelium contains cells without cilia and lacks globulate cells. Some non-ciliated columnar epithelial contain cells. Non-ciliated means it does not cilia and lacks of globulate cell. Now, second part of the epithelial tissue is stratified epithelium. And in this, in contrast to simple epithelium, stratified epitheliums contain two or more layers, means more than one layers. Because of this, it is more durable and can better protect underlying tissue. Now, what is the difference between simple epithelium and stratified epithelium? Simple epithelium contains single layer and stratified epithelium contains more than one layers. And due to more than one layers, it is more durable and can give better protection compared to simple epithelium. Some cell of stratified epithelia also produce secretion. The name of specific kind of stratified epithelium depends on the shape of the cells in the apical layer. First types of stratified epithelium, that is stratified squamous epithelium. Now again, squamous means its cells is flat in shape. Cells in the apical layer of these types of epitheliums are flat, and those of the deep layer vary in shape from cuboidal to columnar. Upper layer cells is flat, and deep layer the shape of the cell is cube shape or columnar shape. The basal cells continually undergo cell divisions and new cells grow. The cells of the basal layers are pushed upward toward the upper side, means apical layer. As they move further from the deeper layer and from their blood supply in the underlying connective tissue, they become dehydrated, shrunken and harder, and then die. At the apical layer, after the dead cells lose their cell junctions and they are sloughed off, but they are replaced continuously as new cell emerge from the basal layer. Stratified squamous epithelial exit in two forms. Means there are two types of stratified squamous epithelium. One is keratinized and second one is non-keratinized form. Keratinized stratified squamous epithelial means the apical layer and several layer deep to it are partially dehydrated, contain the layer of keratin. Now, what is keratin? So keratin is a type of protein. It is the tough fibrous protein. And what is the function of the keratin? It gives the protection to the skin and underlying tissue from heat, microbes and chemicals. The keratin files the cells and organelles die. Keratinized stratified squamous epithelial forms the superficial layer of the skin. Now, non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelial, which is found, for example, lining of the mouth and esophagus, and does not contain keratin because it is non-keratinized, means it does not contain any keratin in their apical layer and several layers deep to it, and remains moist. The organelles remain in these epitheliums. Both types of stratified squamous epithelium forms the first line of defense against microorganism. they give protection against the microorganisms. Now, second types of stratified epithelium is stratified cuboidal epitheliums. This is fairly rare types of epithelium in which cell in the apical layer are cuboidal, means cube in shape. Stratified cuboidal epithelium mainly serve as a protective function, but it also has a limited role in secretion and absorption. Stratified columnar epitheliums, like stratified cuboidal epithelium, stratified columnar epithelium is also uncommon, meaning it is seen rarely. Usually the basal layer consists of shortened, irregular shaped cells. Only apical layer cells that are columnar in shape. And these types of epithelium functions is protections and secretion. And last types of stratified epithelium is transitional epitheliums. And transitional epitheliums is present only in urinary systems and has variable appearance, because the cells of this transitional epithelial tissue are change its shape according to their position. In it is relaxed and unstretched state, transitional epitheliums look like stratified cuboidal epitheliums, except that of the cells in apical layer tends to be large and rounded. And as tissue is stressed, cell become flat. When it is in unstretched, means when it is in relaxed condition, the cell is cuboidal, cell like a stratified cuboidal epithelium. But when tissue is stretched, cell become flat and give an appearance of stratified squamous epithelium. It allow the urinary bladders, generally it is present in urinary bladder, to stretch to hold a very variable amount of fluid without rupturing. Thank you very much.